गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन.
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
गुड मॉर्निंग मैम।
वंडरफुल टू एवरीवन।
यस मैम।
माय वॉइस इज क्लियर?
यस मैम।
यस मैम।
ओके एंड नाउ पीपीटी इज विजिबल टू एवरीवन ना?
यस
यस मैम।
ओके सो इन लास्ट क्लास वी स्टार्टेड अबाउट द फिजियोलॉजी ऑफ सेंस ऑर्गन्स इन फिनफिशेस. ओके सो इन दैट पार्ट फॉर इन लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट the photoreceptor sense organ, that is eye. Okay, so today we are going to talk about the auditory and the chemosensory organ in the fishes. Okay, so first we will take the auditory organ in the fishes followed by the chemosensory. Okay, so the first auditory. So auditory organ means what? The auditory organ means the organ of hearing. Okay, the organ which sense the sound wave. Okay, so today we are going to discuss about the organ of hearing in the fishes. Okay, so anyone can tell me hearing is required? कोई बता सकता है मुझे? Anyone?
क्या मैम?
भागने के लिए मैम।
Required?
भागने के लिए, भागने के लिए।
Balancing के लिए मैम।
बैलेंसिंग के लिए हियरिंग रिक्वायर्ड है. अगर जिसको सुनाई नहीं देता, जस्ट टॉक अबाउट ह्यूमन, जिसे सुनाई नहीं देता वो क्या बैलेंसली चल नहीं सकता? कुछ और बताइए. एनीवन?
बचने के लिए मैम, बचने के लिए,
बचने के लिए, प्रेडेटर से बचने के लिए हियरिंग रिक्वायर्ड है. और कुछ? अच्छा, आज आप और हम इंटरेक्ट कर रहे हैं ना, तो इसमें क्या कहते हैं हियरिंग का क्या रोल है?
समझने के लिए किसी बात को,
कम्युनिकेशन के लिए. इज इट? सो हियरिंग, जैसे अभी आपने बोला इट इज रिक्वायर्ड प्रेडेटर से बचने के लिए, फिर अभी जैसे कम्युनिकेशन के लिए. ठीक है. अच्छा, तो फिशेस क्या है? एज यू नो फिशेस आर द लोवेस्ट वर्टिब्रेट. ओके सो the hearing, the phenomena of hearing or the process of hearing or the organ which is responsible for hearing is present in the fishes. Okay, and from fishes is evolved to the different vertebrates. Okay, up to human. So what happened, as we all know, hearing actually helps in communication. Okay, but when we talk about in the case of fishes, hearing is actually for survive and thrive in the environment. Suppose if you want to अच्छा, आपके पास दो चीजें हैं. If you have a eye and a ear, okay, आँखों से आप देख सकते हैं और ear से आप सुन सकते हैं. आप ये बताइए किस चीज से आपको environment का ज्यादा environment की ज्यादा चीजें आप परसीव कर पाएंगे, देख के या सुन के?
देख के
मैम. अच्छा, अभी कहाँ बैठे हैं आप? अमर्त्या कहाँ बैठे हो अभी?
इन रूम.
रूम में बैठो. तुम्हारे सामने क्या है?
फोन.
फोन है. ओके तुम्हारे पीछे क्या है?
पीछे बाल, दीवार.
दीवार, वॉल है. ओके सो तुम अपनी आईज से एक साथ क्या क्या देख सकते हो? वॉल भी देख सकते हो, फोन भी देख सकते हो?
नो, सिर्फ एक चीज देख सकते हैं,
सिर्फ फोन. या तो फोन देखोगे अगर आप आगे देख रहे हो, या फिर वॉल देखो पीछे.
यस यस.
ओके और अगर आपकी उसी जिस रूम में आप बैठे हो कोई चीज गिर जाती है तो आपको पता चलेगा? आप सुन सकते हैं? एक स्टील की कटोरी गिर गई.
यस यस मैम.
अच्छा, अब उस कटोरी के गिरने की आवाज सुनने के लिए उस कटोरी को आगे गिरना पड़ेगा या पीछे गिरना पड़ेगा?
कहीं भी गिरेगा.
कहीं भी गिरेगा. तो आपने आप विजन से अपने सराउंडिंग को ज्यादा पहचान पा रहे हैं या हियरिंग से?
हियरिंग से.
हाँ, इज इट क्लियर नाउ?
Yes, ma'am.
Is it clear to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, जो आपका जो organ of hearing है उस fish को, जो उसका environment है, environment means जिसमें वो रह रही है, चाहे ocean, चाहे marine fishes हैं, चाहे oceans में है, चाहे river में है, lakes में है, fresh water fishes. So the hearing actually it provides the greater sense of surrounding. Okay, it provides the greater sense of surrounding. With the help of hearing, they can protect them from the predators. Okay, they can understand the environment better with the capacity of hearing as compared to vision and some other thing. Okay, so the role of hearing in communication comes later. Matlab it was considered like that. The hearing or the organ which is responsible for hearing of sound is evolved before the speech. Okay. Means its role in the communication comes later. Okay, so today we are going to study in detail about the organ of hearing in the fishes. Okay, the inner ear or the membranous labyrinth is an organ which is responsible. This is the chief organ which is responsible for hearing as well as the equilibrium of the fish. Okay, there are some other organ also which actually assist in the hearing. Okay, but the main organ of hearing or the chief organ of hearing is internal ear or the membranous labyrinth. Okay, so here first we have to see what is the position of the internal ear. Okay, so you just say the position of the internal ear is just behind the eye. Okay, and it is closer to the the position of the internal ear or membranous labyrinth, or here, or you can see that in the side view, you can just find it behind the eyes, or in the top view, they are present in the pair. Okay, they are present on both the side. Okay, and the this internal ear have one. This is a membranous organ, which have one strong calcareous structure, which is made up of calcium carbonate, which is known as a otolith, and this internal ear have the connection with the nerve, the auditory nerve, which actually sends the sound wave signal to the brain to understand or interpret the hearing. Okay, so we'll first see the structure of the membranous labyrinth or the internal ear. As I have told, this internal ear in the fish, this is the typical structure of the internal ear. It have basically two chambers. Okay, this one is the upper chamber and this one is the lower chamber. The upper chamber is known as utriculus and the lower chamber is known as sacculus. So the sacculus have one small outgrowth which is known as a lagina. Okay, so it has basically two chambers. The upper one is the utriculus, the lower one is the sacculus, and then a smaller outgrowth which is known as a lagina. And a very typical character about the structure of membranous labyrinth is three semicircular canals. Okay, and all these three canals, the anterior canal, the posterior canal, and the horizontal canal, all these three canals, they are opens into the upper chamber, which is known as the utriculus. Okay, and all these three semicircular canals, they are one and have a small swelling. Okay, and this swelling is known as ampulla. So this is the typical structure of the membranous labyrinth in fish. So as I have told, it have two basic chamber, upper and a lower, and in the upper chamber, it have two division. One is the sacculus, another one is the lagina. So the upper chamber, utriculus, then sacculus and lagina, it contains a fluid. This chamber is filled with the fluid. That fluid is known as endolymph, and it have a very high sensitivity cells, which is also known as the sensory hair cells. So the sensory hair cells are present on the wall of on the cavity of utriculus, sacculus, and lagina. Okay, and this cavity is filled with the solid concentration or the solid structure, which is known as a otolith. So there is a three chamber. So basically, the three otoliths present in three sacs, and they are made up of, they are basically the deposition of the calcium carbonate, and their size and shape, it is highly variable among different species of the fishes. Okay, so the three otoliths, they are present in the three sacs. One is called lapillus, another one is the sagitta, and the third one is the estriscus. Okay, So the three semicircular canal and the upper chamber, which is known as the utriculus, is responsible for the maintenance of the equilibrium, whereas the sacculus and lagina, means the chambers of the lower chambers, the sacculus and lagina, they are actually the site for the sense of hearing. Okay, so the upper chamber and canals, they are the organ of equilibrium, and lower two chambers, the sacculus and lagina, they are the site for the sense of hearing. Okay, so as I have told, their shape and structures have the variation in different species. So this is the structural diversity in the inner ear, or the membranous labyrinth of the teleost. Okay, this is a typical in the siluriformes, this is in the cypridontiformes, this is the structure in the globiformes, this is in anabantidiformes, and this is in perciformes. In all structure, what you have seen, there is a three chambers and three semicircular canal. Okay, and these three chambers have three different otoliths. Now, as I have told, this chamber is layered by the sensory hair cells. Actually, these are the cells which actually transmits the signal, okay, the sound wave signal from internal ear to the membrane, sorry, to the brain, okay, through the auditory nerve. Okay, so what happened when this is this typical structure of the sensory hair cell. This is the cell, main part of the cell. This is the nucleus, and it have some cilia. Okay, one long cilia, which is known as the kinocilium, and there are some smaller cilia, which is known as the stereocilia. So when there is a deflection in the cilia, okay, what happened when there is a deflection? Because deflection in this hairy process or this cilium, what happened? Because of the deflection of the cilium, the flow of the ion across the membrane actually occurs. So because of the flow of the ions across the membrane, what happened? There is a generation of the electrical potential. Okay, and this difference in the ionic content in the intracellular and the extracellular fluid, or the polarization, the hyperpolarization of the membrane, actually detected by the auditory nerve. So the brain actually understand the signal of the hearing, or the it sense the hearing. So now we'll see what is the auditory mechanism. Okay, how the structure which is present inside the inner ear, how they actually help in hearing. Okay, and how the brain actually interpret the sound. Okay, we are going to see here. As I have told, this is one of the chamber. Say sacculus. So sacculus have an otolith. Okay, this otolith is a hard structure made up of calcium carbonate. What happened? The density of the water and the fishes is almost same. Okay, the density of the fish body and the water in which they are residing is almost same. So what happened? Whenever the sound passes through, okay, when the sound passes through in a water, because the density of water and body is same, what happened? The body or the fish move in concert with the sound wave. Okay, means if there is a movement in the water, the same movement occurs in the body of the fish also, because the density of the water and the fish body is same. Okay, but the otolith, which is a dense, harder structure inside the inner ear, it has a much more density than the fish body or the water. So what happened? Otolith doesn't move as the fish body moves. Okay, so what happened? Because of the difference of this density between the fish body and the otolith, the movement of the otolith, okay, the aptitude and the phase, okay, in the movement of the otolith is different from the sound wave, is different, okay, from the rest of the body. Means the body density is equal to the water, but the density of the otolith is much more than the body. So what happened when sound wave travels in the body? So the body moves in direction to the sound wave, but otolith is denser, so it have it doesn't move along. So what happened? There is a difference between the motion of the fish body and otoliths occur. So because of the difference in the motion of the fish body and the otolith, what happened? The cilia of the sensory cell, okay, these are, okay, the cilia of the sensory cell actually deflects or delocate, okay. So the deflection of the cilia of the sensory cell is actually cause the movement of the ion or the flow of the ion, which actually cause the polarization, which cause the electrical potential or the hyperpolarization or the depolarization of the sensory cell. And that change in the ion's concentration, okay, along the membrane actually sensed by the brain. And this way, the brain interpret the sound with the help of the inner ear or the membranous labyrinth. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
So now, as I have already told you people, that inner ear or the membranous labyrinth is a main or the chief organ of hearing. But there is one more organ which also helps in hearing in the fishes. Okay, so actually the range of frequency or the level of the frequency that can be heard by the fish is also depends on the proximity between the swim bladder and the internal ear. Okay, here this is the position of the brain. Okay, this is the brain. This is fore, mid and hind brain. This is the brain and this is the internal ear, and these three colors are three different otoliths. Okay, and this is the swim bladder. So what happened? The proximity means the distance between the internal ear and swim bladder actually defines that the fish can be able to hear at what frequency. Okay, so what happened? As I have told, this swim bladder is actually an organ which is filled with the gas. Okay, and the density of the gas is lower than that of the water and of fish body. So what happened when the sound travels? Okay, when sound travels in the water, in the same frequency it travels in the body. But when it comes near the swim bladder, because swim bladder have less density, so what happened? It get easily compressed by the sound pressure wave. Okay, so this compression actually what caused? It caused the change in the volume of the swim bladder. Okay, so what happened? This caused a generation of the stimulus, and this sound stimulus is sent from swim bladder to the internal ear. Okay, which actually cause the stimulation of the hair cell or the highly sensitive hair sensory cell of the inner cell. So it actually aids or it actually in the hearing in the fishes. Okay. So what happened? As I have told, this presence of the retransmission of the stimulus from swim bladder to the internal ear actually enhance the hearing capacity of the fish. And this enhancement of hearing ability always depends on the physical relationship between the swim bladder and inner ear. So some fishes which lack swim bladder, like elasmobranchies and flat fishes, okay, so because they lack swim bladder, so they are not very sensitive to the sound and they have a very narrow hearing bandwidth. Okay, in contrast to the fishes which have the swim bladder, okay, because the presence of the swim bladder, they have the enhanced hearing ability, but that is because there is some modification in the swim bladder. Okay, if you remember the class of the anatomy, we have studied the anatomy of fin fishes. Now, in that, in the skeleton system, we have talked about the Weberian ossicle. You remember, these are basically some of the vertebrae which fuse together and form the Weberian ossicle, is it? So what happened? There are some fishes like carps, minnows, catfishes. Their swim bladder is mechanically linked to the inner ear or the membranous labyrinth via this fused vertebral structure, which is known as the Weberian ossicle. So what happened? because here is a one connection bit direct connection between the swim bladder and the inner ear. Okay, so what happened when there is a change in the because if there is a compression in the swim bladder, what happened? That is stimulus, that sound stimulus traveled through the Weberian ossicle to the internal ear. That's why the carps, the minnows, and the catfishes, they have the better sound hearing abilities. Okay. So there is there are some other species, like in the carps, what we have seen, the swim bladder is attached to the inner ear through the Weberian ossicle. There are some species, okay, in which what happened? The position of the swim bladder is actually extended towards the internal ear, or sometimes they have some structural modification, okay, which actually, because of that, the swim bladder is directly attached to the internal ear. Okay. So this type of modification is found in this species, like some in the squirrel fishes, in butterfly fishes, and Atlantic cod. Okay, what happened? Because there is a very less difference, very short difference between the internal ear and the swim bladder, so the stimulus needs to travel a short distance. Okay, so this modification or the closing of the swim bladder towards the internal ear actually helps in, or it actually enhances the hearing capacity of the fish. Okay, then there is one very interesting examples of the fishes which belongs to the order Clupiformis. Okay, you know the Clupiformis, like herring, sardines, sharks, they actually moves in school. Okay, so these fishes have one specialized structure. They have a pair of elongated ducts, gas filled duct. Okay, so this is a duct which is originating from the swim bladder and it connecting to the internal ear, and this duct actually have a small bubble at the end, okay, which is also filled with the compressible gas. So what happened? And it is directly attached with the utricle. So in the presence of the gas bubble in the close proximity to the internal ear, what happened? It actually enhanced the ability of the swim bladder to stimulate the internal ear. So it increased the hearing sensitivity to the wide range of frequencies. There are some fishes which can actually hear the ultrasonic sounds wave also. Now, so this was about auditory organ. Here I would like to share you some of the video which actually show how this organ helps in converting the sound wave into the hearing signal. Okay.
Many fish species have calcium carbonate structures in the inner ear called otoliths, which are housed in the sacculus, utriculus, and lagina. Each of these otolith organs differs in size and orientation. The otoliths are also much denser than water and the fish's body tissues, and vary in overall size and shape among species. Each otolith organ consists of a solid mass, sitting on sensory hair cells. A sound propagates through the body tissues of a fish, and since the otoliths are denser, they move or oscillate at a different amplitude and phase in response to the sound waves than does the rest of the body tissues. The difference between the motion of the fish's body and the otoliths causes cilia on the hair cells of the inner ear to bend. This difference between the motion of the hair cells and the otolith is interpreted by the brain as sound. Each otolith organ has a different orientation, which, in addition to the variable orientation of the hair cells, enables sound direction to be determined.
Yes or no?
बीच में रुक गया था मैम वीडियो
मैम आवाज बंद हो गया था बीच में
हाँ आवाज बंद हो गया था
अच्छा मैं एक बार और फिर से बेसिक अच्छा मैं एक बार फिर से और ट्राई करती हूँ ओके
Many fish species have calcium carbonate structures in the inner ear called otoliths, which are housed in the sacculus, utriculus, and lagina. Each of these otolith organs differs in size and orientation. The otoliths are also much denser than water and the fish's body tissues, and vary in overall size and shape among species. Each otolith organ consists of a solid mass, sitting on sensory hair cells. A sound propagates through the body tissues of a fish, and since the otoliths are denser, they move or oscillate at a different amplitude and phase in response to the sound waves than does the rest of the body tissues. The difference between the motion of the fish's body and the otoliths causes cilia on the hair cells of the inner ear to bend. This difference between the motion of the hair cells and the otolith is interpreted by the brain as sound. Each otolith organ has a different orientation, which, in addition to the variable orientation of the hair cells, enables sound direction to be determined.
रुक गया
मैम
रुक गया था कहाँ
47 मिनट 47 सेकंड
उसके आगे प्ले नहीं हुआ ओके
difference between hair cells of the inner ear to bend. This difference between the motion of the hair cells and the otolith is interpreted by the brain as sound. Each otolith organ has a different orientation, which, in addition to the variable orientation of the hair cells, enables sound direction to be determined. One factor affecting hearing sensitivity in fishes is the proximity of the inner ear to the swim bladder. The density of the gas within the swim bladder is much lower than that of seawater and the fish's body. As a result, sound waves cause the walls of the swim bladder to oscillate. If the movements of the swim bladder wall are transmitted to the ear, this results in the stimulation of hair cells of the inner ear. The structure of the inner ears and swim bladders vary greatly in different species of fish. Thus, it is difficult to predict hearing abilities of marine fishes based on their anatomy alone. One factor affecting hearing sensitivity in fishes is the proximity of the inner ear to the swim bladder. The density of the gas within the swim bladder is much lower than that of seawater and the fish's body. As a result, sound waves cause the walls of the swim bladder to oscillate. If the movements of the swim bladder wall are transmitted to the ear, this results in the stimulation of hair cells of the inner ear. The structure of the inner ears and swim bladders vary greatly in different species of fish. Thus, it is difficult to predict hearing abilities of marine fishes based on their anatomy alone. One group, the clupeiform fishes, have gas ducts that extend from the swim bladder and come in direct contact with the inner ear. These ducts end in bullae that contain a gas bubble. The bubble is in close proximity to the inner ear and results in the transformation of sound pressure waves to particle motion. Some clupeid species, such as the American shad, can detect high-level ultrasonic frequencies up to 180 kHz.